Who here will have kids when they grow up? Here's another question. Would you give your kids superpowers? I know, it's a silly question, but with the current technologies that we have today, would you do it? The answer is probably yes for most people. Now, I want you to imagine a situation about 20 years from now, and you have a daughter. Her name is Emma. Emma is a genetically modified human being. She is perfect. She has above average height, athleticism, superhuman senses, and hyperintelligence. Her best friend Olivia, on the other hand, received no genetic modifications at birth. Looking at them side by side, differences are clearly apparent. You can clearly tell that Emma has been the genetically modified one. Emma is much more beautiful, much more refined, and much, much smarter. Emma is also immune to a slew of deadly diseases, such as Alzheimer's and cancer, and is free from all genetic diseases. Olivia, on the other hand, is failing in school and is often sick. Everything seems so amazingly perfect for Emma and not for Olivia. So, coming back to the present time, I want to tell you that this futuristic world is now here. CRISPR-Cas9 is a new genetic tool which allows scientists to make changes to human DNA. You can think of CRISPR as a genetic pair of scissors. With this genetic pair of scissors, you can cut the unwanted piece of DNA and then trigger the cell to replace this unwanted piece of DNA in a specific way. It's a relatively simple concept. However, the real question is, do we really want to use this genetic pair of scissors? Well, let's think about it. These days, we have a wide range of human beings, and with that, we have a huge amount of range and ranges of thinking. And with this kind of CRISPR technology, we have the ability to completely rewire the human genome. By using this CRISPR technology, we will be able to completely overturn the human race. We can make all humans perfect. And, well, let's think about it. If we use this CRISPR technology, we might have many defects, and some people will disagree with it. Well, what if your child has sickle cell anemia? Or you are passing down a cystic fibrosis gene to all of your descendants, causing pain and suffering for all? Well, in that case, you would want to change it. And this CRISPR technology, it becomes one of the most alluring. Because with the ability to create humans with no genetic defects and being able to customize your baby, you can get whatever kind of baby you want. However, one of the most overlooked reasons to why you would have a CRISPR baby is the price. Raising a child today could cost $250,000, a substantial amount of money. And the healthcare cost alone is $20,130. But with this new kind of CRISPR technology, we will be able to cut costs on almost everything on raising a child. Now, with the CRISPR technology, there are endless possibilities. Now, look here. We have a perfect shot. In archery, there is a target shown here, and in the middle of the target, there's a small dot. This arrow hit this dot and straight in the middle. This can only be described as a perfect shot. Well, does this perfect shot apply to humans as well? Well, perfection is the same for everybody. Perfection is tangible, unchangeable, and solid. In society today, we have a wide range of people. There are people who are geniuses and not so geniuses, and they all offer wide ranges and points of view. And with these wider ranges and points of view, it's what allows the human race to move forward. However, with having everybody be perfect, we won't have this kind of uniqueness anymore. This uniqueness brings us forward, and without this uniqueness, we won't be able to create wider ranges of thought and making more different kinds of ideas. Now, there's no mistake that this kind of CRISPR technology has infinite potential. So we can completely overturn what the human race is, and we can completely change what the human race can do. But what kind of human race will we be? Thank you.